Hey everyone, Cameron here again with Car Audio Now, bringing you another cool head unit to review and walk through and give you a demo of. Today I have a marine grade head unit. It's the Fusion Apollo RA670. This head unit is part of a larger series of head units, amplifiers, and other products, the Apollo series. They're really focused to designed to bring multi-zone entertainment into your boat or yacht. It retails for around $480 right now, which is sort of in the middle of the road these days in terms of head units with this type of functionality. But it has a lot of cool things that set it apart from some of the other traditional single din style head units. Things like Wi-Fi streaming and Apple AirPlay, but also some Fusion specific features like Party Bus Network, Fusion Link compatibility, just to name a few. And I'll get into some of these features in more detail as I get into the review. So today I'm gonna open up the box for you. I'm gonna pull it out and show you things like the size, components, features, et cetera, et cetera. But more importantly, I'm gonna also hook this up to my test bench, power it on with some other Fusion specific or Fusion products and show you some of the cool features that the head unit has, including the Fusion Link app and so on. So let's get started. Let me open up the box and show you what's inside. So I went ahead and pulled everything out of the box to show you the various components that it comes with. This is everything that's in the box. And from the left to the right, first you've got your three harnesses. These are the key harnesses, starting with sort of your main power harness here. And what's nice about these is they're water sealed. You can see that there's like a rubber seal here. You essentially wire these all up and then you can plug them into the unit after you're done wired. The power harness here has things like accessory, your constant power ground, things like illumination and amplifier remote turn on. But it also has the built-in amplified signal output wires, where if you were planning on wiring your speakers directly to the head unit itself, you'll find the speaker wire to do that. That's these white, gray, purple, and green here. So it can do that. And this head unit puts out 26 watts RMS per speaker channel if you're looking to do that times four, like most other head units. You have your zone, then getting into the zone control here, you have two additional plugs. These are for three zone outputs. These are the preamp outputs in addition to your aux input. So what they did is this head unit has three zone outputs. Each zone has left, right, and then a mono sub. So that's what you see these oranges are. So you have red and white, which is, you know, your left and right, and then you have sub, and you have that times three for each zone. Next, you have obviously the head unit itself. I kept it in the packaging, but I'll pull that out next. You have the outer seal here and screws for mounting this to your panel or your dash. You have the manuals here. You also have these little, these are covers. These are trim covers. They essentially cover up the screw holes here. You can kind of see it on this. The seal, they'll cover up the screw holes on the head unit. You have your packaging and your manuals, installation instructions. And then finally on the right, you have what's called an NMEA 2000 cable. And for those of you who don't know what NMEA is, NMEA stands for National Marine Electronics Association. It's basically a protocol for communication in larger boats like yachts. And it enables connectivity to a much broader, larger system or network of electronics on a larger boat. For smaller boats like wakeboards, ski boats, it's used for things like the wired remote that you put on the stern of your boat next to the swim step, right? Those sort of things. That's what this is. So let's dive a little bit more into the head unit. I'm going to pull everything out and dive into the head unit now. All right, so taking a look at the head unit, the first thing that I'll call out here is that this is a compact design. It's not a single din, it's not a double din, it's not a din and a half. The cutout here is about 5 1/8 inches roughly by roughly 2 inches. So it's smaller than a single din, it's not really any of the above, right? And out of the box, it has this rubber cover that you can use to protect it long-term, the buttons and the screen from, you know, spray or water spray or the sun if you're not using it. and it comes from the factory with that. And then underneath, obviously, you're going to find all of the control buttons, the control knob, and the information screen. This Fusion unit has a 2.7 inch glass LCD display. This is one single pane of glass. The screen is here. You'll see that when I turn it on in a little bit. It's a 2.7 inch screen. And when this thing is installed properly, the face here is rated at an IPX7 in terms of water resistance. That's important to kind of call out. Obviously, this is a marine grade head unit. And below the screen, you have series of buttons. These are your pretty standard buttons. You have power. This is also your mute. If you tap on it, mute on and off. The menu button where you can access the settings and just your general menu items. The source here, it pops up a source menu. You can choose the different sources. And if you hold this, it'll open up the party bus menu as well. And then you have your previous, pause, play, and next for songs. Now, looking on the back, on the left here, you remember those three harnesses that I showed you? Well, this is where they get plugged in, right? With the zones and the power harnesses. And you have a little fuse here, for protective measures. You have your USB input, Sirius XM radio tuner input. If you have a external Sirius module, this is something that it doesn't come with, but it's obviously compatible with it. And then over here, you'll see something that's probably a little bit more familiar in the home stereo world. You have a fiber optic or digital audio in, an optical input. And this is for if you want to connect the source of your TV into the broader stereo of your boat. Again, this is for larger boats more than it is like a wakeboard boat. But if you have, you know, a multimedia or a media system in your boat and you want to hook it into this, you can do that via the optical input. Below that, you have your standard antenna for FM AM radio. You have your NMEA 2000 cable that I talked to a little bit earlier, and then you have your Ethernet here. And the Ethernet input, it is really used to hook into a larger network of Fusion head units to control different head units all from one. So if you were on one level or in one section or room of your boat and you wanted to control somewhere else, you can connect all of the head units together via Wi-Fi, but also via this Ethernet. And just to take a step back, so you have zone control. Each of the head units has its own zone control. You saw that in the wire harness where you have zone 1, 2, and 3, right? That's what this unit controls. But then if you take it a step above that or further back, you can have a network of head units as well, and you can control multiple head units from one. And this is really the bread and butter of some of these Fusion products, the Apollo line. You know, they're designed all to work together in one seamless connected network. You can configure them all together out of the box. It's really a cool and unique feature that Fusion has brought to their Apollo series products, and even more, you know, more granular, like their speakers and subwoofers via the software that's on this. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to install this in my test bench. I'm going to fire it up, give it power, and walk through some of the features themselves in real time. So let me go install this in the test bench now. All right, so I've installed this head unit into my test bench. As you can see, it's hooked up to power right now, but I also have it hooked into some speakers on my test bench and directly up to USB to this. This is an iPhone 6S, I believe. It's one of my test iPhones. So it's hooked up to USB and a source of music. But more importantly, it's also hooked up to where I can access the head unit in Fusion Link. And I'll open up that app in a little bit and show you and cruise around there too. So I'm just going to start by cruising through some of the features on the head unit here and give you a firsthand look at some of the key things I think are important to call out. And, you know, to start, let's talk about connectivity. And you can see here, and I already said this, I'm hooked up to USB, which is also indicated here on the top left as iPod. But you can connect to this unit in a number of different ways. I kind of already touched on this, but it's actually impressive how many ways you can connect to this head unit. Some of these connectivity options include, you know, your direct to USB, which is what you see here. You have Bluetooth, which is pretty standard. Apple AirPlay via Ethernet. This unit, it's important to call out that this unit doesn't have Wi-Fi. So if you want to use AirPlay, you're going to need to connect this unit to another AirPlay compatible system or just a larger network. To where you can access AirPlay, or you're going to want the RA770 or one of the other Fusion head units that have Wi-Fi built in, right? You choose. And then there's obviously auxiliary. So this also has an RCA input on the back, so you can use your traditional headphone or whatever. No matter what source you choose here, you can use whatever the source of your streaming audio that you like, whatever your preference is. Right now you can see a song that's on here from Spotify that's actually from this phone, but you can also play from Pandora, SoundCloud, Apple Music, or directly from, you know, a USB drive that has music on it. So you choose your source of music and it's going to be compatible one way or the other. But just to access the connectivity settings and sort of the source menu, you're going to connect or you're going to click on the menu button here, and I'm going to walk through some of these other options. Go into the settings, and then you're going to go to source. And this will give you a list of all of the options. And right at the top, you can see your standard AM, FM, and then Sirius XM. Now, Sirius XM, you have to have a separate controller in order to enable it. Pretty standard. It's very common in head units to have an additional Sirius XM controller in order to enable that capability of the head unit. Below that, you have aux 1. I talked about that. This is an RCA aux input on the back side of the unit where you can plug in a traditional auxiliary input or a headphone to RCA adapter, right? Your typical headphone jack that you plug in. Below that, you see USB and iPod. So when a phone or something very similar to an iPod is plugged in, it's going to default to iPod, right? And that's what you saw earlier. If it's not, you're going to see USB. Basically, USB and iPod are the same. There's one USB input, and it's compatible with a variety of devices for music. So, moving on further below that, you see BT or Bluetooth. Now, as long as this is enabled here, and I'll just go in and you can see source enabled, right? You can see the name and auto connect, right? As long as this is enabled, you're going to be able to go to your device that you're trying to connect to, and you're going to be able to connect directly from your device. So you go into the Bluetooth settings, and then you're going to find this unit, and then you're going to connect to it. And then all of the features that are available via USB that you're going to see me go through are also available on Bluetooth. Important to note that. Further on, you see optical, and this is one of those other interesting ways that you can connect to this unit, right? So optical is one of those things that you don't really find on an automotive application or most other marine head units for that matter. I pointed this out on the back of the head unit when I was reviewing it, but this is really for the scenario that you have an entertainment system on the boat with TVs and such, and you'll essentially take your optical audio cable and plug it into this unit so that you can play audio from your multimedia system through the head unit and ultimately to the speakers that are connected to this head unit, right? And that'll extend your multimedia system directly to whatever's connected here. So again, this is probably more of a use case for like yachts and larger boats that have staterooms and bigger multimedia systems, but pretty cool. And then below that, the last one I'll go through here is another, you know, cool and unique option in my opinion. It's not too common. It's AirPlay, right? And you know, kind of like you'll use AirPlay to play a video on your Apple TV or something of that sort. You can essentially use AirPlay to connect to this. But the caveat here is that you need to either have this unit connected to the internet via the Ethernet cable that's on the back of this, or connected to in some fashion to another receiver that's compatible with AirPlay and Party Bus. But the biggest difference between this unit and one of the biggest differences between this unit and the RA770 that we reviewed is Wi-Fi and its ability to play AirPlay without any other sources for that matter, right? You don't need to connect this to an AirPlay or Party Bus compatible device or a larger network via an Ethernet connection in order for those two features to work. Kind of a bummer here, and it already went back out to the home page here, but kind of a bummer, but Wi-Fi might not be necessary for people who are just using this unit as a secondary head unit in a larger boat, or I don't know, if you have a wakeboard boat and you don't really care about Wi-Fi and AirPlay or Party Bus to connect to other units, you know, and you're okay with the Bluetooth or USB connectivity, like that, these features might not even matter to you. So I'm in the homepage again. That's all I'm going to cover for the sources, though. There's a couple, you saw a couple other options in there. I've left a reference link to the manual so that you can kind of get into some of those other more intricate, more technical sources. These are kind of the key ones that 99% of the people are going to use on a normal use case or a normal boat. So the next thing I'm going to cover off on is zone control. And this was one of the features that I personally love about, you know, all of Fusion Apollo series head units. I installed, last year I installed the RA770 onto an Axis A22 wakeboard boat, for those of you who don't know. And it was perfect for separating, zone control was perfect for separating out the cabin speakers from the tower speakers and the subwoofer. And it enabled independent control of each zone or joint control, and I'll show you that. So when you click on the control knob, you're gonna see your zones appear. And if you scroll down to each of them, you can see you can control each zone independently, or you can control them jointly by selecting all. So depending on what you select, so I click and now it changes, and you can see I'm controlling all. Turn that down, and then I click again, and now I'm gonna select zone two, right? And you can see zone one and three are not following zone two. So I can change each of the different zones independently of each other. And this is what I'm talking about when I say independent control. On the wakeboard that I installed the RA770 on, you know, zone one here was for cabins. That's all the interior speakers of the boat. Zone two was the tower speakers. And then zone three was actually the subwoofer, because I wanted quick and easy access to the subwoofer control in its own zone. You know, you can select each and control the zone independently. And, you know, if you're putting this into a yacht, you can also use this for things like staterooms or galleries or different rooms in the boat. It's pretty cool. Each of the zones here can be, you know, renamed to whatever it represents on the boat. And then more importantly, you can actually control or tune each of the zones and create a DSP profile for each zone depending on what amplifier and speakers or subwoofers that it's sending signal to, mainly for you know, Fusion specific speakers and subwoofers. I'll get that into it a little bit more when I get into the Fusion Link app in a minute. So I'm gonna let this kind of go back to the home page here, and then we'll get on to the next feature. Now I'm gonna walk you through how to get to the zone settings. And mainly I just want to show you what kind of configuration and control you have over each zone directly from the head unit. So to get to the zone settings, you're gonna click on the menu, and then you're gonna scroll down to settings again. And then you may have seen this earlier, but below or above the source, you see zone. And now once you're in the zone that you choose, you can see a variety of controls and settings for each zone. First thing to note is the name, right? Like I said, you can rename each of these different zones to whatever you want. So like if I wanted to rename this, you know, the cabin speakers, right? I can do that directly here. If you go back, you see other things like zone limit, volume limit. This is just a limit. If you have speakers, let's say in the cabins, that you don't want to go over a threshold so that you don't blast blast the folks in let's say the front of the boat when you're turning up the volume here, because the speakers in the rear are a little louder just by nature. You can kind of set volume limits so that they don't that the zone doesn't meet or go exceed that threshold. And then you have a couple other things, balance, right, left and right, external and internal amp gains, and then you can set the output of this zone to either be a mono or it's by default a stereo output, which is just left and right. You probably use that on like a mono subwoofer installation. Let me go back to the home screen now. So the last thing I'm gonna touch on here before I get into the Fusion Link app and show you how that integrates with this head unit is the audio settings. And in addition to the zone settings, you can also go in and adjust some of the high level things on the head unit by navigating to the settings in audio here. So I click on the menu and then I click on audio. And now, you know, just like the zone settings, you can go into each independent zone and control that zone audio configuration. And it's also just as pretty much just as high level as what you saw in the zone settings earlier. You know, there's a lot of the control that's housed in the app, but you know, this is nice because it gives you all the high level things that you need. And it's also important to call out that if you don't use a dedicated zone, like I explained in my use case for a wakeboard boat, I use this dedicated zone for the subwoofer control. If you just hook in the subwoofer to the normal zone controls, or you know, your subwoofer is in line with other speakers in a single zone, this is where you're going to control the subwoofer level. And that was one of the reasons why I actually pulled it out and dedicated a zone, is because this is two steps too deep for me. I wanted to have direct access to that subwoofer control when I clicked into the zone control. That's just me. A lot of people don't use that. There's a lot of use cases that don't require that either. So you can go through and you can control things like the treble, mid and bass. And then there's, you know, a loud functionality that basically will give you a little bit more volume. Very high level, like I said, but it's nice because it gives you the basics that you need in order to you know, tune your system or tune that particular zone. If you want more in-depth tuning, you're going to want to go into the app. So, which is a good segue here, because the next thing I'm actually going to do here is give you a close-up of the app and how powerful it is and how it integrates with the head unit. I'm going to go through some of the tuning and the DSP configurations and how you apply those to the head unit. You know, I did that separately in my review of the Apollo amplifiers. Check that video out if you're more interested in seeing, you know, some more detail on that. But it's the app that really houses the bulk of the functionality and the controls that exist for these Apollo head units. And it's very powerful. So let me hook that up here, and then I'm going to start to show you the intricacies of the app. So I've switched over to a screen share. You're looking at the screen of my iPhone. I've already downloaded the Fusion Link app. So let's go ahead and open it up and show you what it looks like. And again, I'm already connected to USB. So you can see that indicated at the top left here, the purple icon. But the look and the feel of the app and really the functionality is gonna be the same whether you're connected to the head unit via Bluetooth or USB like I am right now. And the first thing you'll probably notice here is that the home screen on the app is pretty much a mirror of what the home screen looks like on the head unit. The information about the song or the music that you're playing, the controls here at the very bottom. You know, you can really control almost every aspect of the head unit here directly on the app without touching the head unit, which is really nice in a boat where you're kind of walking around. You might not always be in front of the head unit. So let me go through some of the features here in the app and give you a peek at some of the important stuff. First, let's talk about the source options. Just like on the head unit, you can control and select the source that the unit is using by clicking the top left here, the purple icon. Boom, you see AM, FM, auxiliary, all of the same options that I already went through on the head unit.
And it also, if you're hooked into a larger network of Fusion head units via the Ethernet cable on the back of the head unit, you can also head over to the group here and it'll search that network that you're connected to for all the other Fusion stereos that are on that network. And you can select the stereo or the head unit that you want to be the source of this head unit, right? And what's cool about this is that it's gonna tie this the source of this head unit to the source of the other head unit without any synchronization problems, right? It'll sync up the music exactly so that these two head units are playing at the exact same time, which is really, really cool if you're in a larger boat, but also, you know, if you wanna connect just in general, any use case that you wanna connect two head units to the same source, to sync up the audio and the music, also known as party bus, right? So let's go back home. And so also similar to the head unit, you can control the zone volumes directly from the app. Like I said, this is one of the really cool features if you're walking around your boat or you're at a sandbar and aren't in front of the head unit, which is, you know, apart from when you're driving the boat, that's probably most of the time. You'll tap on the zone volume button down here on the bottom right of the app, boom. And here you are, you have all of the controls that you saw me walk through on directly on the head unit just on your phone. And you can take and drag the zone that you want to change, right? I'm doing zone one and it'll all respond independently. Or you can take and drag up all and change the volume. So you can control the volume at any place within your boat that's accessible or within the range of Bluetooth. You know, for my personal wakeboard boat, I have a separate equalizer to do this, but this is really nice to have. And I also kind of talked about how I separated out zone three, for example, as my subwoofer zone on the Axis A22 that I did. This was so that I could just go into the app at any point and crank up the subwoofer volume. But it's important to note that you can also do this within each of the zones. You don't have to dedicate a subwoofer to a zone. Each zone has a, on the back of the head unit, has a subwoofer output that you can adjust the subwoofer level independently. So that kind of debunks the use case that I had. If you don't want to use a dedicated zone to power a subwoofer, you can just go into the sub level here and it's very easy to control the subwoofer level output. Very cool. So let's go back to the home. Next, let's go into the settings. And I mentioned this earlier, but the settings on the head unit are really kind of a light version of the settings and configurations that are available in the app. In particular, the tuning and DSP configurations that are expanded upon within Fusion Link and within the Fusion Link app. So let's start out with zone control configurations. Again, right away, when you click on the settings here on the top right, you'll see the zones to click into. So let's click into one and it's gonna look very similar to what you saw on the head unit again, with the exception of one major component here, and that's the DSP settings. So, you know, you can see your loud, you can see, you can also see things like tone, right? You saw this in the head unit where you can control the three band equalizer, very high level stuff, amp gains on the bottom and then the mono app, all things that you saw directly on the head unit. But let's dive a little bit deeper into the DSP settings, right? And this is basically just downloading, this screen is downloading the existing DSP settings onto your phone so that it'll show you what's on there. But here you see three options to start configuring your zone. Internal amplifier at the top, which is the head unit's amplifier. And if you don't have an external amplifier, this is the option you're gonna use. It's basically using the wiring and the internal amplifier within the head unit to power whatever speakers you are. But if you do have an external subwoofer amplifier or monoblock, both of these are external, by the way. You can use these options to tailor the configuration of the amplifier too. And there's a couple of different options in the external amplifier and subwoofer amplifier settings versus the internal, in particular selecting the amplifier that you're using. I'll go into that in a little bit more detail here. So let's go ahead, and I'm actually going to go into the internal amplifier configuration since it's probably the most common. And right away here, this is where you're going to configure your zone DSP and tuning profile. And you can see three kind of big components. I'm going to go through them kind of quick, but you basically at the top, you're going to select your speaker type. So these are the speakers that you are ultimately connecting up to your amplifier. And I kind of touched on this, but this is, again, these DSP profile and the DSP configurations are really dedicated for Fusion systems. And you can see that in here when you're trying to select the speaker type, that's all Fusion, only Fusion products. So let's go ahead and select a pair of speakers here. I already have this selected. This is what I have set on my test bench, the XS-F65X. And I'm going to go ahead and select that. And, you know, it's worth calling out that you can't, so you saw that I selected one speaker type for this zone. You can't select two different types of speakers for the same zone. It just doesn't work that way. So each zone has to have one type of speaker in order to leverage this settings. Next, you're going to select the environment. So are your speakers in a cabin or are they in a room? Are they installed basically in a roof without walls in that room? You know, this will tell the tuning profile to adjust things like frequencies to ultimately optimize the sound of the environment. The indoor settings, for example, and I'm just going to click in here. So the indoor settings, for example, might not be as heavy as like heavy on the high frequencies as an open air environment, right? So if you're in an enclosed area, the high frequencies resonate a little bit better than in an open air environment. So selecting the environment just tells the configuration, the DSP, how to tune the frequencies based on some of these presets. I'm just going to go ahead and select open air again, and then go back. So now your profile is pretty much configured. The one last thing, in the scenario that you're using an external amplifier or a subwoofer amplifier, you're going to select the external amplifier. And this is a list of all your Fusion products. I think I was using beforehand in the Apollo series review that I did earlier. I had selected the Apollo 4-channel amplifier. I'm just going to select that. Now you have the speaker environment and external amplifier set. And this is pretty much it. You have two or three additional settings here on the bottom just to tell your profile whether there's two speakers on one zone connected, right, or two pairs of speakers, whether or not the channel is bridged, and then, whether you've hooked up a separate tweeter, a pair of tweeters, to that same channel. So this configuration, this profile for zone one, you can see at the top, zone one external amplifier, this is completed now. And I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna deploy that configuration directly to the head unit. Go back. And you can see at the bottom here, send DSP settings. And send DSP settings is ultimately gonna upload this zone's configuration that we just did directly to the head unit. And I'll go ahead and do that right now. Boom, you can see it's done. And you'll do that to every zone that you have on this head unit. So that's pretty much it for the zone and DSP configurations. So the only other thing that I want to call out with the app here before I wrap it up is to walk you through some of the general settings and call out some of the differences between the head unit and what's in the app, right? And if you go into the settings on the top right and click on the general, mainly what I want to call out is, when you have multiple stereos, you can connect to those multiple stereos in the app, right? So let's say I had three different stereos that were within range of Bluetooth. I can go in and I can select and I can tailor those directly in the app, or I can switch between them, which is kind of cool, something that's not obviously in the head unit, right? Back into the general here. Another cool thing is just in general, the software updates, right? You can do this on the head unit too, as long as it's hooked into your phone. You can go in and you can update the software of the head unit at any time since your you know, your phone is typically hooked into internet. And what you'll do is you'll go through and you'll download the version and then you'll upload it directly to the head unit. So kind of cool. You can go through, easily update and grab any sort of software updates that the and changes that they might be making to the app to the head unit, right? Their Fusion is constantly updating the app, updating some of the software for the head units to improve the user experience. So that's kind of cool that you can just go and do that. NRX power, I'll just note. So if you're using a separate remote, you know, something that you throw on the stern of the boat for control over volume and so on, this NRX power, you'll basically just turn that on. It'll enable that remote to be you know, accessible and connect to the head unit.
So that's really the bulk of what I wanted to call out in the app here too. I hope it covered all the core features that you're looking for in the app and on the head unit here. I tried to keep it brief. If not, drop a comment. I'll try to answer it. Thanks so much for watching. I'm always trying to cover some of the latest and greatest automotive and marine audio products. So if you like this content here, please subscribe. It helps us out. And it tells me I'm, you know, putting out content that you guys like. Also check out our website, caraudionow.com, for more reviews and recommended products. Thanks again.